In this video, we will discuss about pressure. Let's see the diagram first. This is your first diagram and this is your second diagram. In the first diagram, you can see the pointed end is towards the wall, and in the second diagram, the blunt end is towards the wall. Same force F is applied in both the cases. What you will find? In the first case, the nail will be driven into the wall, but not in the second case. That is, effect of force is more in the first case, and effect of same force is less in the second case. Now, what is the difference between these two? Here in the first case, this force acts over a very small area, whereas in the second case, this force acts over a large surface area. So, we can say that effect of force depends on the surface area over which it acts. Greater is the surface area, smaller will be its effect. Smaller is the surface area, larger will be its effect. So, effect of force depends on the surface area over which it acts. Now, in the first case, if you increase the magnitude of this force, you will find that the more the nail is driven inside the wall. That is, by increasing the magnitude of force, the effect of force is increased. So, effect of force depends on two factors. One is your the magnitude of the force, and second is surface area over which it acts. A new physical quantity is introduced which includes both the effects, and it is pressure. Pressure is defined as the measure of the effect of force over a given area. There is another term, thrust, which refers to the force which acts in a direction perpendicular to the surface. For example, our weight acts in a direction perpendicular to the surface. So, weight is an example of thrust. Quantitatively, pressure is defined as the thrust per unit area. Pressure is equal to thrust by area. These straps that is provided in our school bag is wide enough. Why it is so? Have you thought about it? You know that the pressure is related to the surface area. The effect of force will be less when surface area is more. So, this is an application of this fact that the school straps of the school bag is wide enough so that pressure is less on the shoulders of our students or the man who is carrying the luggage. So, by decreasing the surface area, the effect of force can be increased, which finds many applications in our daily life. That is why the ends of the nail is pointed one, so that it can be driven easily with a minimum effort. It is easier to cut vegetables using sharp knife, because in case of sharp knife the surface area is less, so effect of force will be more. So it is easier to cut vegetables using sharp knife. Similarly, by increasing the surface area, the effect of pressure of force can be reduced, which finds many applications in our daily life. For example, railway line is laid on sleepers. Why is it so? When we use sleepers, the surface area gets increased, so effect of force is reduced. In large vehicles, the rear wheels are double, so that surface area will be more and effect of force will be less. In case of high-rise buildings or dams, their base area is made wide enough so that pressure is less, effect of force is less. So this is all about pressure, or you can say solid pressure. In next video we will discuss about liquid pressure.